Hello and welcome to the very next lecture on Lagrange's interpolation formula. So in the last learning video, we have seen how to find out missing terms from the given data. Now, therein we have seen how to find out a single missing term. Now, let us make it more interesting by finding out two missing terms from the given data. Now, as you all know that this pandemic period is going on, and suppose you have a data where you can see the number of COVID infected from a particular city. So you have a data for March, April, May. You don't have a data for June. You have a data for July, but you don't have a data for August. So as you can see here, you don't have a data for June and you don't have a data for August, but you have the data of other days, for example. So with the help of given data, you can easily find out the approximate number of infected person in the month of June as well as in the month of August. Okay, so this Lagrange's interpolation formula can help you in finding out such things. So let us see how to solve such problems. Okay, so this example says find two missing term from the given table. So as you all know that the very first thing that you need to do is do the naming. So I will name this as x0 and the corresponding value y0. We have to find out this, so we can neglect it. No naming for the time being. X1, Y1, X2, Y2, and that we also have to find out. Now, the C here. Here there are two missing terms we have to find out. So forget about the second one. If you forget about the second one, this becomes a problem of single missing term. So we will solve the problem for a single missing term. Once we get this value, we will forget about this and consider the remaining data to find out the second missing term. Okay, so let us do this. So we always start with by the Lagrange's interpolation formula, by the Lagrange's interpolation formula. We have y is equal to f of x is equal to, now we have three terms, so we can write it as x minus x1 into x minus x2, x0 minus x1 into x0 minus x2, sorry, into y0. Plus the second term into y1. So it would be x minus x0, x minus x2, x1 minus x0, x1 minus x2. Okay, now write down the next term. The very next term would be of y2. So this is x minus x0, x minus x1 upon x2 minus x0, x2 minus x1. Okay, now you have all these values, substitute it and try to get the answer. So this is x minus x1. So we have to find out for the value of 3. So you can write it here, put x is equal to 3 and using given data, in this above formula, we get what? Y of 3 is equal to x is 3 minus x1, that's 1. Then we have 3 minus x, that's x1, x1 is 4, sorry. Then 3 minus x2, that is 8. divided by x0, that's 1 minus 4, 1 minus 8 into y0. What is y0? 8. Plus the next term, x, that is 3. 3 minus x0, that is 1. 3 minus x2, that's 8, divided by 4 minus 1 into 4 minus 8 into y1, that's 11. Okay, plus the very next term, that is 3 minus 1 into 3 minus 4 upon 8 minus 1 into 8 minus 4 into 32. Okay, now do these calculations. So, I want you to pause the video, do these calculations and come up with your answer. So I hope you might have found out the value of this y of 3. So what answer you are getting? Y of 3 is equal to 8.7858. That is what I am getting as y of 3. Now we got the value of this. Now we have to find out this missing term. So you forget about this. Okay, and find out this. So same formula we will apply. In place of x equal to 3, you just need to put x is equal to 10 and do the calculations, get the value. You can write here second part. For second part, you can write put x is equal to 10. Put x is equal to 10 and using the given data and using the given data, we get, what we get, y of 10 is equal to, y of 10 is equal to x minus x1, x minus x1, x1 is, write down this same, in place of x you just need to substitute 10, so this is 10 minus 4, into 10 minus 8 and then 1 minus 4, 1 minus 8 into y1, that is 8, plus the second term, is x, that is 10 minus x0, that is 1, into 10 minus x2, that would be x1 now. Something is going right or not. Yeah, 3 minus 4, this is x1 is 4, x2 is 8, okay. X0 is 1 and x2 is 8. Yeah, that's correct. That's correct. Upon x1 is 4 minus 1, 4 minus 8 into y1, that's 11, plus the last term into 32. So this is 10 minus x0, that is 1, into 10 minus x1, that is 4, upon 8 minus 1 and 8 minus 4. Okay, that is what we get. Now you solve this and try to get the value of y of 10. So if you want, you can pause the video for few seconds, try to get these values and then resume the video with your answer. So I hope you might have got the answer. So what would be the answer that you are getting? You should get 49.7857. Okay, so this is what I get. You may also get the same thing. Someone may get 49.7858. That is also correct. Okay, so this is what we have in this learning video. For any queries, you can write on the comment section. So thank you for watching this learning video and enjoy learning mathematics.